two random variables, x and y, are described by the joint PDF fxy of x comma y is equal to xy divided by 96 into a, where x is taking the values from 0 to 4, y is taking values from 0 to 1. Find mx, my, sigma x, sigma y, sigma xy, and rho. Find mx, my, sigma x, sigma y, sigma xy, and rho. So you have to find the mean value of the random variable x, mean value of the random variable y, variance of, that is a standard deviation of x, standard deviation of y, covariance of x and y, correlation coefficient, rho. So how can you find the mean value? So before that, first evaluate a value. What is a? First find a value. Integral 0 to 4, integral 0 to 1, axy divided by 96, dx dy is equivalent to 1. Because the volume under probability density function must be equivalent to 1. That is the fundamental property of the joint probability density function, 24. So therefore, what is fxy of x comma y now? Any cancellations? Y divided by 4. From 0 to 4 and 0 to 1. Now evaluate the mean value. So mx is equal to integral 0 to 4, integral 0 to 1 xy divided by 4 into x, because x fxy of x comma y dx dy. What is the value? Do it. So this is x square y dx dy. 1 by 4 can be taken out. For x square, you do the integration for x and y separately. So when you are integrating with respect to x, y is constant. When you are integrating with respect to y, x is constant. Similarly, my is equal to, again, 0 to 4, 0 to 1, this is y, xy by 4, dx dy. Eight by three. Okay. This one 2 by 3. So how can you find the sigma x? Sigma x. See, the variance sigma x square is equivalent to expectation of x minus mx whole square. This can be written as integral minus infinity to plus infinity, and this is minus infinity to plus infinity. So we have x minus mx whole square fxy of x comma y dx dy. So if you consider the PDF, of x only, we write it as minus infinity to plus infinity x minus mx whole square fx of x dx. But here the joint PDF is given, the sigma x square can be written in this. Otherwise, what is the way you find fx of x first? What is fx of x? It is a marginal density of x. This is given. Can we find fx of x? We can find. Then this sigma x square is expectation of x minus mx whole square. Like that also you get. Otherwise, you can directly substitute. Find the value here. Similarly, this sigma y square can be written as minus infinity to plus infinity, and this is also minus infinity to plus infinity y minus my whole square fxy of x comma y dx dy. What is sigma xy? Is a covariance, is it? Sigma xy is equivalent to expectation of xy minus mx into my. We know mx, my. We have to evaluate fx, expectation of xy also. This is integral 0 to 4, integral 0 to 1. This is xy, fxy of x comma y dx dy minus mx into my. So 8 by 3 into 2 by 3. So 16 by 9. Is that right? And this is equivalent to see, this value is also equivalent to 16 by 9. Because in this case, sigma xy is equivalent to 0. Why? Why sigma xy equivalent to 0 here? See, if you observe this, fxy of x comma y, can I write this as x by 2 into y by 2? Fxy of x comma y can be written as x by 2 into y by 2. Okay. That is, fxy of x comma y can be written as fx of x into fy of y. So, two random variables, x and y, are independent to each other. The random variables are independent to each other. This value will be equivalent to covariance equivalent to 0. For independent random variables, covariance is 0. Okay, anyhow, evaluate 0 to 4, and this is 0 to 1, xy into fxy of x comma y is xy divided by 4 dx dy minus 16 by 9. What is sigma x square? 8 by 9. Sigma y square? 1 by 1/8. This value. This is x square y square by 4 dx dy. Integrate it. We already know these two values. Mx is known to us. My is known to us. We have to find this one, because the covariance sigma xy is equal to sigma xy is the covariance of xy. Covariance of xy is equal to sigma xy. That is expectation of xy minus mx into my. In the previous class, we already obtained this expression. So what we call this expectation of xy is the what this quantity indicates. This is a correlation, that is RXY. Expectation of XY is called as the correlation between the two random variables X and Y. So here, this equation is the relationship between the covariance and correlation and the mean values of the random variables. Covariance is equivalent to correlation minus MX into MY. See, this value, this integral indicates a correlation. See, if the two random variables are independent, the correlation is equivalent to how much? Zero? Yeah. Yes? See, the two random variables are independent, that expectation of XY is equivalent to expectation of X into expectation of Y. That is not zero. But the covariance is zero. See, for independent random variables, covariance is zero. The correlation is not zero. Are you getting zero here? Because this integral will also evaluate to 16 by 9. So therefore, obviously, the rho value is correlation coefficient, sigma xy divided by sigma x into sigma y. This is also equivalent to 0 because sigma xy is. See, here from this example, it is very clear the two random variables are independent. Therefore, if the two random variables are independent, this expectation of xy is equivalent to how much? Expectation of x multiplied with expectation of y. So, which is equivalent to 8 by 3 into 2 by 3. That is 16 by 9. So, here this value, right? This value is equivalent to 16 by 9. This value is also equivalent to 16 by 9. We are getting 0. That is, in such problems, first identify whether the two random variables are independent or not. If the two random variables are independent, the simplification can be, that is, the problem can be simplified, is it? That is, instead of evaluating this integral, double integral, you can directly write expectation of xy is equivalent to expectation of x into expectation of y. That we already know. This is equivalent to expectation of x and this is expectation of y. So that you can substitute and directly you can say that sigma xy equivalent to 0 and rho is also 0. Understood?